Hello, my name is Wunping. Over the Wire is a free online platform for interested personnel to learn and practice security concepts in the form of playing a game. It is like a CTF, capture the flag, whereby the flag in question here is the password to log in to the next level. As of today, there are 32 stages in total for Bandit Wargame. In this video, I'll be going through level 0 to 6. Without further ado, let's get started. For level 0, it is pretty straightforward. The level goal has stated that the purpose of this stage is for you to log in to the host via SSH service that is running on port 2220. The username and password of Bandit 0 has been provided to you. As shown here, the password for level 1 is stored in a file called readme, which is located in the home directory. For me, I am running a fresh Kali Linux virtual machine. So, if you want to hack alongside me, you can download the same from their website. So for beginners out there, SSH is short for Secure Shell Protocol. It is a very commonly used service in real working environment for people to establish remote connection to any machines. Usually, SSH service runs on port 22 by default, but in this case, the Bandit host is running it on port 2220. Therefore, we need to specify -p2220 in our login command. Run ls to view the files in the current directory. Run cat readme. And there you go. This is the password to go to level 1. For level 1, we need to retrieve the password from a file called dash, which is located in the home directory. Now, let's log in to Bandit 1. Run ls to view the files. As you can see, if you run cat dash directly on your terminal, it will get stuck. This is because when cat sees a dash symbol like this as a file name, it will treat it as a synonym for standard input or standard output. Therefore, to view the content of the file that was named as dash, you have to use other methods, such as using its absolute path, like cat./dash. And there you go, this is the password to go to level 2. For level 2, the password is stored in a file called spaces in this file name. First, let's log in to Bandit 2. Run ls and you can see the file that you are looking for. A bit of background here. In real working environment, it is pretty unconventional to have spaces in file names. Usually, if people really has a need to, they will use underscore or dash to still connect the words together. Otherwise, your terminal may not know the multiple words belong to each other and they may thought that they are different commands written one after another. To ensure that your terminal know that they belong together, one method is to use backslash to escape the space. You can do it easily here by making use of the tab for auto-completion. There you go, the password to go to level 3. Alternatively, you can also provide the full name like this. For level 3, the password is stored in a hidden file in a directory called in here. If you just run ls-l, you won't see anything because the file is hidden, as mentioned in the level goal earlier. Therefore, you need to run ls-la, whereby the A enforces that your command lists all entries, including those starting with a dot to indicate hidden files. Now, run cat.hidden, and there you go, this is the password to go to level 4. For level 4, the password is stored in the only human readable file in the in here directory. Now, run ls-l and you will see that there are 10 files available. However, only one of them is human readable and contains the password. By using dash at the front of the file name, the author of this challenge is intentionally making it challenging for you. Even with quotation, cat will still attempt to process it as a flag, hence the error. Therefore, similar to level 1, you can use absolute path to view its content by adding .slash at the start. As you can see, the content of the file is gibberish because they are not human readable file. We can use the file command to view its file type. Apparently, only file 07 contains ASCII text. Let's view its content using cat command. And there you go, this is the password to go to level 5. For level 5, the password is stored in a file somewhere under the in here directory and has all of the following properties: human readable, 1033 bytes in size, not executable. Well, that is very specific. As shown, there are 20 directories here, and we should not be using the cd command to change directory into each of them to find the password file manually. Instead, we should make use of the find command in order to identify the file containing the password. The find command is very useful in the real working environment. Be it you are a security analyst acting as a defender or a penetration tester acting as an attacker. It allows you to find files quickly based on the properties that are determined by you. The dot specifies to search from your current directory, meaning the 20 directories that you see earlier. Dash readable are basically files that are readable as we learned from the previous level. Dash size is the file size, and in this case, 1033C means 1033 bytes. There you go. This is the password to go to level 6. For level 6, the password is stored somewhere on the server and has the following properties: owned by user Bandit 7, owned by group Bandit 6, 33 bytes in size. Well, this is another challenge with very specific properties for us to search. To solve this challenge, we need to use the find command again, but this time on a larger scope of search. Instead of dot, we will be using slash this time in order to search the entire server. As the flag name itself has suggested, dash user is to specify the user who owned the file, and dash group is to specify the group of which the file belongs to. As shown, there are a lot of permissions denied. However, a file named bandit7.password seems to be what we are looking for. There you go. This is the password to go to level 7. Just to share another trick, you can add the dash type F flag to specify that you only want a regular file and not any other file types, such as directory, a symbolic link, and etc. Since we know that we are looking for a text file that contains the password, it is definitely a regular file. Also, you can add /dev/now to make it nicer and easier to read, like this. So what actually happened? When you run a command on your terminal, the output will be displayed on your terminal by default. However, using the greater than operator, you can redirect the output of any command to somewhere else, such as a file. By default, everything is redirected. However, in this case, we only want to filter away the error messages. So instead of just putting a greater than operator, we use two greater than operator, which only redirects the standard error messages. With this, I have come to the end of my step-by-step walkthrough of Over the Wire Bandit Wargame series for level 0 to 6. I hope this detailed walkthrough has been useful to you in your learning and help you understand the new concepts that were being introduced through the challenges. Learning cybersecurity can be fun. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Stay tuned for more videos in the series.